All right, so today we are installing the batteries for our power bank. We've got 400 amp hour lithium batteries from Renogy.
So I'd like to thank the team at Renogy for really stepping up to support us on our boat life adventure by sponsoring these videos. They sent us charge controllers, a massive inverter, a battery monitor, 6 solar panels, and a ton of other incredible supplies we're gonna be installing on our boat.
So it's gonna be a bit of a puzzle figuring out all these wires. And it's a little more stressful than just like working on an off-grid system because you do need the boat engine to work when it's supposed to work. Ooh, wow, that's so heavy.
There we go.
Nice work.
All 4 fit.
Sweet.
That's cool.
So this is the on-off switch I just bought, and this is gonna go for the starter battery.
So we went from this to this to this. So that's the general idea. Almost. 5th time's the charm. Here we go. Look at that. Now you can turn the starter battery on and off once I connect this. So I'm just trying to figure out where to put this vent. It's gotta go like somewhere like that. So much work to get one cable from there to there. So in order to install the batteries, I want to put them all 1, 2, 3, and 4 all on that side and leave room over here in case we ever want to increase the battery bank or install other electrical components. But because of the angle of the boat over there, the back battery is like resting on the hull, which I don't want. So what I realized in my sleep last night is I can just raise this entire section of batteries up. So the batteries are gonna rest on these 2 wooden boards, which are gonna get screwed. Put that through there. And this is gonna wrap around the battery. Check this out.
So I think even if we capsize, our batteries are not gonna go anywhere, so that's good at least. All right, so the inverter is all wired up. We got the positive, the negative, the ground, and it's just gonna go in here. So it's gonna be a pretty tough installation, which is why I connected all the wires already, because it's gonna just barely fit. But we have a vent in there, and it's gonna vent through the top, and it'll have like quite a bit of air through the bottom, so it'll get good airflow. It'll just be like very difficult to access.
Today is a very special part of the electronic boat build because Dana is helping me.
Hi.
I have a helper finally because my back has been hurting bending over this section for days on end.
So I'm gonna screw this input cable, is that what it's called?
Uh-huh.
Back in to the DC converter. It's got the grease on it. Now I just hope my greasy fingers don't drop the screw. Oh, this is interesting.
Mm-hmm. This is why I have back problems.
Yeah, I can see it. And trying to film it alone. I'm here to help, Blue. Ay, ay, ay.
This camera doesn't do justice to how small this section is.
Yeah. I don't know how to get my arm in there.
Yeah.
Ah! Da da da!
Thank you. I'm gonna turn this guy on.
Okay.
And turn the key. Wow.
You did it.
That's crazy. I didn't think it was gonna work.
I'm really proud of you.
Whew.
You relieved?
That was a big week of electrical work.
Woohoo!
Ow!
Oh.
Oh no.
That's never closed.
It was dripping here, so that's why I closed this. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
It's okay. So what's going on?
We're gonna fix the wiring on this switch because the DC to DC charger is turning on when the battery's on.
Yeah.
But it should just turn on when you turn the key. So.
Wow. So, first one.
So here we go.
So still no green light.
Which is good.
Yep. Hey! We've got a green light.
Really?
Yeah.
Woo!
Great job.
Thank you. So I guess this is the ignition switch, or it's, yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Must be.
Things have gotten very chaotic in here again. No matter how many times I clean this space, this is kind of how it ends up every night, just because there's so many different components that are needed to build this. All of these things. And hopefully by tonight I can clean this all up and have a nice, clean, organized boat.
Smash.
is killing me. Lights. Look at that. We got light. We got light.
Woo!
Oh man, I did not think it was gonna work. But it's all working, which is really lucky because I do not want to go in there and try and fix it right now. But I've decided the second something breaks, I'm just gonna remake the whole system in a much more accessible place. Whew. The whole 12 volt system on the boat doesn't work. The bilge pump doesn't work. The lights don't work. I might just have to start from scratch and build a whole new system in a better place. The hope was to build it in this area because it would take up the least amount of space.
But it means it's pretty much impossible to figure out what's going wrong because everything has to be connected. And once it's connected, you can't get in anymore. Yay. Got this pipe in, got them hanging here.
I've been down, I've been everywhere, but I'm all right.
Everything. Let's do a check.
Okay.
B to D. D, B. Correct?
Yes.
A to B. A, B.
Hey! It works!
Woo! This is crazy. 1 week of work later, second attempt on the system. Things seem to be working. We got lights. We got radio. Now we just need solar.
Oh my gosh.
They're lighting up.
They're all lighting up. That didn't happen last time, did it?
No. Ah!
That's amazing. Should we plug in the panels?
Yeah. It's working.
Woohoo!
Yeah. I think it's working.
Really?
Yeah.
Woohoo!
I think it's working.
So now let's just check some wires.
Yeah, and then we can finish this boat project.
What? Power station. So I thought I would give you a quick tour of our electronic system now that it's up and running and working beautifully. Here we have our 12 volt panel. This is where we have access to everything that's 12 volt on the boat. So this could be things like our running lights, our starboard lights. If we had a refrigerator, this would be the spot that we would go on. Next, we have an inverter switch. So it's really nice to have the inverter switch. We didn't have that in the van, but it allows us to turn on power to the inverter if we are using things like our computer. But if we're not using it, we can turn it off, which saves us a ton of power. And then to the next, we have a Renogy battery monitor, which is also brilliant because we can see how much percentage-wise we've used the batteries. And so if it's getting really low, we can stop working and wait for the sun to come back. And this way, we don't hurt our batteries. This beautiful cabinet, we actually made ourselves. And when you open it here, voila, Here you can see our charge controllers, and they have a lot of ventilation through these holes, and we have our on-off switch, and this is for what again?
Do you want to work on the panels or anything?
Oh yeah, this is our on-off switch for the Renogy solar panels. And this way, if you have to do any work on them, you can easily turn it off, so it's safer that way. Welcome to the heart of our electrical system. This is Lou's pride and joy. He worked very, very hard on this. We have four lithium batteries. They're each 100 amp hours, so we have 400 amp hours total. And then we have this lead starter battery. But overall, we're really pleased, and I just wanted to take a second and thank our patrons. You guys are making our life so much better, and we're really grateful for the support. And yeah, that's it. Thanks, Renogy, for all the stuff. We are loving it. And if you actually want to get any Renogy things, we have an affiliate link in our description box below. Until next week, see you later.